In continuation of our last session on the 4-bit parallel adder designing, we were about to finish regarding the programming part. U1 is going to be what? See here, this one. Now for this full adder, my input is A0, B1, but or S of 0 means this, C1. C1, for your confusion, I am letting the S of 0, S1 and S2. Fine. So here it is, S of 0 is there, sum of 1 and S of 1. Same thing is going to be done for last full adder. In last full adder designing, here instead of signal, what we will write down, carry out. And of this is all about my designing. Just for your recalling, here again once I put the full adder programming. And this I made by just directly by the full adder, just to give you once again flashlight for the like data flow designing. 3 input and 2 output, this is my entity declaration. And then in the architecture, what is sum? A XOR B XOR C. And what is carry? That is A and B, or B and C and C. That is going to be exactly this, na? A plus B, B plus C and C plus A. Fine. Now we will start next. This is the particularly waveform of my 4-bit adder, and as we discuss about the number of gates, area, power dissipation, all details are available in utilization summary. The number of 4 input LUTs, number of occupied slides, inputs, bounded IOBs. Now after this, next VHDL programming is SIO2, that is serial in serial out 4-bit shift registers. What we need in this, one clock is needed, single bit input and single bit output. Yes, one confusion which most of the student used to have, ma'am, we are mentioning 4-bit, then why we are taking one single bit input? So my dear students, we are taking single bit input because it is serial in serial out. One bit is going to be serially in, and that 4-bit is control is going to done by this signal which we will use inside the architecture. Fine. So in our architecture, what is going to be there? I am using one signal, which what will be the role of signal? Signal is going to be here. This part is my signal, this part is signal, and this means whatever output of one is going to feed another, that is going to be propagate as a signal. Process is a clock, begin, clock tick even as clock is 1. When clock is on the rising edge, what we need to do? We are taking this stamp as a signal, stamp callo as callo, whatever we are going to use. So what we are doing, stamp 3 down to 1 is going to transfer to stamp 2 down to 0. And time 0 is assigned to S of I. And if and process, and finally S of 0 is assigned to time 3. What do you understood? See, I took one signal of 4 bit. T3, T2, T1, T0. Here it is. Suppose T0, T1, T2, T3. The logic is only this. That's it, the finish of SISO. If you design using a structural, it is going to consume 25 lines, which is going to finish in a 3 lines. So this operation, I just want to let you know what I am doing. Temp, this much is going to occupy in my next line in what? T2 to T3, T2 to T0. And what finally I am doing? Temp 0 jo finally move hoga. Isse the bit is going to serially move, and finally temp 0 is going to reach here when in a fourth clock, and it is going to assign as temp 3. And this particular thing is very much clear through this waveform. See, here I inserted single input. After the 4 clock, in D out it comes out. Then second clock pay, the input is 0. So we just come in. Is it clear? So this is a very easiest programming for the SISO.